Welkom op Baselworld 2019. Hier worden dit jaar weer alle nieuwigheden op horloge- en juwelengebied getoond voor de hele wereld. Lopen jullie met me mee?
We hebben een aantal nieuwe dingen meegenomen. We breiden de Big Three uit. Naast de Monaco en Carrera krijgen we ook de Autavia dit jaar als een eigen lijn erbij. Het is voor de jonge avonturier een sportief horloge met een knipoog naar vintage. Je ziet wel meer merken die komen met vintage, wij ook. En je ziet dus veel brons terugkomen, groene platen, bruine platen. Dat is toch wel echt een trend dit jaar.
Ja, dat is moeilijk om te verklaren. Maar wij zien wel ook inderdaad jonge meiden die gewoon echte klassieke, hele dunne, platte horloges kopen van ons. Wat gewoon een hele klassieke wijzerplaat heeft. En daar zijn ze helemaal weg van. Dus die trend zien we wel in een jongere groep terugkomen. Onze collectie is in het algemeen heel klassiek, waarin veel leer terugkomt. Wat kleine diameters van kasten, 40, 38,5, damesmodelletje 26. Dat gaat veel meer terug naar vintage en history. Dus daar connecten wij sowieso al mee.
Basel 2019, I think, is a good cuvée, you would say, in the wine business. We have a lot of beautiful novelties. A nice addition to the Happy Sport collection, which is really the DNA of Chopin, is the oval shape with the steel bracelet. It's one of the best sellers of the fair already. Already some pieces preview of Cannes, which is around the corner. As we're the official partner of Cannes, we accessorize the beautiful actresses from all over the world and actors. And for Cannes, we have to do 72 pieces, which go in the red carpet book. You know, it's going back to Basel, going back to Cannes. And I always say Basel is the appetizer and Cannes is the main course.
I bring almost 80 to 90 new models around my new theme, which is the desert, the American desert. And we call this new collection Born to be Wild. I felt very inspired by the desert because I find the desert so wild and so huge and with the finest of the diamonds. I love this contrast. The hardest part to design a jewelry is not the design, it's the execution, definitely. You have to find the right balance between the flexibility, the, of course, to be secure, and my obsession of erasing as much as I can the gold, because diamond is still the beginning and still now my inspiration.
A lot of trends in diamond industry, especially also with the new market. China is a huge market, and the young Chinese women, they all love diamonds. And maybe thanks also a little bit to the social media, are brought much closer to the younger generation, and a lot of younger clients, they're very successful very early, so they spoil themselves. They're not waiting until they get the present, they go and get it, which is a nice thing.
You are already a professional in the watch industry for many, many years. What are you bringing new to the Breitling company?
I think we have a very balanced collection with pieces from the 1950s, so re-editions, in particular the Navitimer 806, which is the most mythical of the Navitimers, then to very modern products like the Super Ocean. So it's very much, I think, a collection which will suit the more classic watch lovers and then the more modern and more sporty oriented clients of ours. I really think that Breitling is a cool and relaxed alternative to, I would say, the more conservative brands out there. The sports we use in advertising, with surfing, which is a total different lifestyle, I would say, than Formula One or tennis or golf.
Is there anything about Breitling I didn't ask you but I should have?
Oh my God, we would be here the whole night. And even though I love you a lot, I don't want to spend the whole night in this office with you.
Thank you very much.